In this video, we're continuing on with the Tangents to Circles worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Geometry section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, in numbers 9 through 12, we're going to be finding the perimeter of each polygon. Assume that lines which appear to be tangent are tangent. Now, an important theorem that we're going to be using states that tangent lines extending from the same endpoint are congruent. So, number 9, looking at this top tangent line and looking at this bottom tangent line. However, looking at it from the point where they intersect the circle, because they come from the same endpoint, those lines are congruent. Now let's look at the tangent line coming from the endpoint towards the left. This tangent line segment will be congruent to this one, since they're tangent lines that extend from the same endpoint. And then finally, coming from this endpoint, again we have two tangent lines, therefore those two segments are congruent. So knowing that 10.5 is congruent to another 10.5, and we know that this total distance is 23.2, therefore since this distance is congruent to 11.2, then we can solve for this distance, because 23.2 minus 11.2 equals 12. So this segment is 12, and since it's congruent to this other segment, then that segment is also 12. So now we have numbers associated with each of the segments within the triangle at number 9, therefore we can calculate each of the sides. Well, we know that this side is 23.2, so we're going to take 23.2 and add that to the addition of this side, which is 10.5 plus 11.2. And 10.5 plus 11.2 is equal to 21.7. So 23.2 plus 21.7 plus 10.5 plus 12. 10.5 plus 12 is 22.5. So 23.2 plus 21.7 plus 22.5, the lengths of each of the sides of the triangle and number 9, will give us 67.4, the perimeter of the triangle in number 9. In number 10, we have a quadrilateral, so we're going to be dealing with four sides. However, remembering our theorem about tangent lines, we know that this segment is congruent to this segment of 13. Therefore, this segment is 13. And since we know that that segment is 13, we can calculate this segment, since the total distance of that side of that quadrilateral is 25, we can take 25 and subtract 13 to get 12. And we know that that segment of 12 is congruent to this segment, therefore that length is also 12. However, the total distance of that side is 21.8. So we're going to take 21.8 and subtract 12 to get the other distance. 21.8 minus 12 will be 9.8. So this segment is 9.8, and since we have that tangent line as well as another tangent line, that 9.8 is congruent to this other segment, which in turn is also 9.8, and we also have that 4.6 is congruent to 4.6, because that is another tangent line. So now we're going to add up each of the sides of this quadrilateral, or since each of them are split into two segments, we'll add up the 8 different segments. So two segments are 13. So we'll have 13 plus 13 plus two segments are 12, 12 plus 12 plus two segments are 9.8. So that's 9.8 plus 9.8. And then finally, two segments are 4.6. So 4.6 plus 4.6. Now I'm going to simplify this problem and then do out the math. Since we have two of each of the segments, I'll say 2 times 13 plus 2 times 12 plus 2 times 9.8 plus 2 times 4.6. If I was to distribute the 2, you can see that that 2 would get multiplied to each of the terms. So adding 13 plus 12 plus 9.8 plus 4.6, I'll get 39.4, and we're multiplying that quantity by 2. So 2 times that 39.4 is 78.8. So the perimeter of the quadrilateral in number 10 is 78.8. Moving on to number 11, we have another triangle. And we have one missing side length that we need to figure out. So we're going to be adding 22.7 plus 23 to that missing side length. As you can see, each of these lines are tangent lines. Therefore, this length of 14 is congruent to this length of 14. And if we take 23 and subtract 14, 23 minus 14, we'll get 9. So this length is 9. And then if we take 22.7 and subtract 9, we'll get 13.7. So 13.7 is the other missing segment of that side of the triangle. So since we have that one segment is 14 and the other segment is 13.7, 14 plus 13.7 will give us that total side length, which is 27.7. Now we can plug in that missing side length of the triangle, 27.7, in order to solve the perimeter. So if we have 27.7 plus 22.7 plus 23, we'll get 73.4. So 73 4/10 is the perimeter in number 11. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 12. In number 12, we have another quadrilateral. We can see that 5.4 is congruent to 5.4. And again, I can say that those segments are congruent because they're tangent lines that extend from the same endpoint. So this side length is the missing side length. I have all other side lengths, so we need to figure this out in order to find the total perimeter. So this first side of 18.4 plus the second side of 21.9 plus the third side of 20.5 plus that missing side length will give us the total perimeter. So since we've solved for 5.4, we need to solve for the other segment that makes up that side, which happens to be congruent to this segment. However, we don't know that segment, so we have to solve for this segment, which is congruent to this segment. And in order to solve for that segment, we need to solve for these two congruent segments. So we have 18.4 and 5.4. 18.4 is the total side length, and if we subtract 5.4, we'll get this missing segment, which equals 13. So knowing that that segment is 13 because it's a tangent line that stems from the same endpoint as another tangent line, then this segment is also 13. So we'll have 21.9 minus 13 equal to the other segment of that side, which is 8.9. So since this segment is 8.9 and it's a tangent line that extends from the same endpoint as another tangent line, then it has a congruent segment of 8.9. Now that we know this segment, we need to subtract that length from 20.5 to get this segment, which is congruent to our missing segment. So 20.5 minus 8.9 equals 11.6. So this segment is 11.6 because it's a tangent line that extends from the same endpoint as another tangent line, then this segment is also 11.6. So now I can add those two missing segments up to get the missing side of my quadrilateral. So 5.4 plus 11.6 equals 17. So plugging 17 in, I'll have 18.4 plus 21.9 plus 20.5 plus 17, which is 77.8. So 77 8/10 is my solution in number 12. For the last four problems on this worksheet, we're going to be finding the angle measure indicated and then assume that the lines which appear to be tangent are tangent. Now, an important formula to remember comes from a previous worksheet, and that formula is that an inscribed angle equals half the measure of that intercepted arc. So number 13, we can see that this is a radius, and if we continue to extend that, we will form a chord. So we have one chord and another chord stemming from the same endpoint or coming out of the same endpoint where that inscribed angle is 63 degrees. So 63 degrees equals half of that intercepted arc length. let's make this point A and this point B. So that's arc A, B. So 1/2 times arc AB will give us that arc measure. So if we multiply both sides by 2, we'll get that arc measure when we multiply 2 to 63 degrees, since 1/2 times 2 is 1. So arc AB, that measure is equal to 2 times 63, which is 126. So 126 degrees is the measure of AB. Now, since I figured out that this arc length AB was 126, this other arc length will be 180 degrees minus 126, and that's because I formed the diameter, which cuts the circle in half. Let's make this arc AC, so arc AC plus 126 degrees equals 180 degrees. So if I subtract 126 degrees from both sides, I'll get that arc AC is equal to 54 degrees. So if arc AC is 54 degrees, note that the central angle from A to the center point to C will also be 54 degrees, because remember, a central angle is congruent to that intercepted arc. Now there's an important part of the directions which allow us to assume that this angle is a right angle. And that's because a tangent line intersects a point on the edge of the circle at 90 degrees with the radius. So now we have 54 degrees as one angle, 90 degrees as another angle, and we need to solve for that last angle of the triangle. So we're going to use the triangle sum theorem, which states that all the angles in a triangle add up to 180 degrees. So if we take 180 degrees, that's going to be equal to our angle A of 90 degrees plus the angle of 54 degrees plus, we'll call this missing angle measure X. So 180 degrees equals 90 plus 54, which is 144 degrees, and then we're adding that to X. So all we need to do is subtract 144 from both sides. And doing that, 144 will cancel out, so I'll be left with X, and that's going to be equal to 180 minus 144, which is 36 degrees. So 36 degrees is that missing angle measure in number 13. Moving on to number 14, again, I can assume that this is a right angle because it appears to be a tangent line. So the measures within a triangle add up to 180 degrees. So if our missing angle, let's call that X, we need to first solve for angle Y, which 180 degrees, which, looking at this larger triangle, that's going to equal 90 degrees plus 44 degrees plus Y. So 180 degrees equals 90 degrees plus 44 degrees is 134, and we're adding that to Y. So when we subtract 134 degrees from both sides, we'll get that Y is equal to 46 degrees. Now, stemming from angle Y, that's an inscribed angle. Therefore, this arc length created by that inscribed angle, the intercepted arc essentially, is double the measure of that angle. So that inscribed angle of 46 degrees equals half the distance of that arc. Let's call that arc A to B. Half the measure of arc AB is equal to 46 degrees. So multiplying both sides by 2, 2 times 46 degrees is 92 degrees. So 92 degrees is equal to the measure of arc AB. And since 92 degrees equals the measure of arc AB, you can see that looking from the center of that circle, that we have a central angle of 92 degrees, because the central angle is congruent to the intercepted arc. So the central angle of 92 degrees forms a straight line with our missing angle X. Therefore, X plus 92 degrees will equal 180 degrees. So 180 degrees equals X plus 92 degrees. So all I need to do is subtract 92 from both sides. And in doing that, 180 minus 92, I'll get 88 degrees equal to X. So X is 88 degrees in number 14. Now remember, we can assume that lines that appear to be tangent are tangent. That means that this angle is 90 degrees and this angle is 90 degrees. Also remember that the angles within a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. So this angle is 90 degrees and this angle is 90 degrees, and we know that that third angle is 117 degrees, we can solve for that fourth angle. So what we'll do, we'll take 360 degrees and we'll subtract 117 degrees plus 90 degrees plus 90 degrees. So that'll be 360 degrees minus 117 plus 90 plus 90 is equal to 297 degrees. So if we take 360 and subtract 297, we'll get 63 degrees as our solution in number 15. So that missing angle is 63 degrees. And lastly, in this worksheet, we'll go over number 16. Assuming that this line is tangent to the circle, this angle is 90 degrees. So given triangle sum theorem, looking at this larger triangle, each of the angles add up to 180 degrees. So 180 minus 52 degrees plus 90 degrees will give us that missing angle. 52 plus 90 is 142. So 180 degrees minus 142 degrees equals 38 degrees. So this angle is 38 degrees. And notice that that is an inscribed angle. It's formed by two chords that share a common endpoint. Therefore, we can calculate this arc. Remember that arc multiplied by 1/2 equals the measure of that inscribed angle. So if we double the measure of that inscribed angle, essentially multiplying 38 by 2, we'll get the measure of this arc. So 38 times 2 equals 76 degrees. So this arc measure is 76 degrees. And notice that the measure associated with that arc is also the measure of this central angle. So the central angle is also 76 degrees. And since this is the diameter, we can take 180 degrees and subtract 76 degrees. 180 minus 76 will give us our missing angle of 104 degrees. So 104 degrees is the solution in number 16. And again, we use triangle sum theorem to calculate 38 degrees. And then we use the fact that an inscribed angle is equal to half the measure of the arc. So essentially doubling that inscribed angle to get the measure of the arc. And we know that a central angle is congruent to its intercepted arc. And because that central angle formed a straight line with our missing angle, we could subtract that measure from 180 to get 104 degrees. And with that, we complete this worksheet. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any comments, leave them in the comment section below.